Today we got something new, and this is, I hope I say his name right. I used to be paid. I hope I said it right. Bro, please forgive me. I do not want to smoke, young brother. And this is why you should hate Lil Mabel. I ain't gonna hold you, like, hating is a powerful word. I wouldn't say I hate, more like I could say dislike someone, but hating is like, yeah, if I hate someone, I try to stay away from all that type of energy, bro. It's all about, you know, the cool, calm, positive energy over him. But yeah, but let's hear what brother got to say, man, because I've been trying to, like, check out one of his, I've been wanting to react to one of his vids, man. But yeah, let's hear what the brother got to talk about, bro. How y'all day been, man? Anyway, let's get to it. Let's check it out.
What's good, YouTube? It's Justice. I used to be Pay, and today I'm back with another video. And in this video, I'm going to tell you why you should hate Lil Mabu. On my channel, I typically don't hate on people.
Yeah, I would say hating is a little powerful.
You know what I'm saying? Like, real hate, man, that's like an art form, man. You know, it's like you like a born a hater, you know, like myself.
Nice,
man.
You know,
I may critique or criticize somebody, but it's never from like a place of hate. It's usually just me making an analysis of that person's career and or music without any real personal bias placed on how I feel about that person specifically. Now, I may make videos about how I feel about people and artists. I've done that before, but for the most part, when I talk negatively about someone, it's just music and or their career. It's never like me personally having a vendetta against, like, I don't know, Drake. Like, if I just really, really didn't like Drake, kind of like Charlamagne the God.
He's gay, straight, and Drake.
But this video will be different, I'm not gonna lie. Sometimes I just really don't like a person. And if you know anything about me and my content, especially on TikTok, you know that I have never liked Lil Mabu. I wouldn't say that I exactly hate him. I think hate's a really strong.
Probably just don't like his music. I mean, like I said, I don't really listen to him like that. I hear a little here and there. And I think I react to when Patrick said something about him. I don't know, man. I can't remember. It's been long, though.
Strong word, and it's mostly for the title of this video. But I really don't like the guy, and I will hate on him. I think you can hate on somebody without actually, like, truly hating them. I don't think those two things, like, walk hand in hand necessarily. But one of the best things about being a content creator is that you can take your dislike for someone and turn it into content. And not only turn it into content, but potentially turn it into content that might make you some money. But I don't just want to get on here and be like, I hate Lil Mabu, he sucks. I want to be a little bit more creative with it and give you some real reasoning as to why I don't like Lil Mabu and why you really shouldn't either. So if you're going to leave a comment being like, bro, you're just being a hater. Okay.
People like that, they all gonna say stuff like that, man. When people say stuff like that, they don't even watch the full vid. That's what I'm getting for them.
And if you're gonna take a screenshot of my thumbnail and be like, oh my god, people are so negative nowadays, they're so miserable, they just hate on anybody that's successful.
I don't give a fuck.
It's my channel. I'm going to do what I want. I'm not miserable. I just really don't like the dude. And I don't think anybody who really considers themselves a hip hop fan should either. And for a quick little insight on Lil Mabu, if you have no idea who he is a white drill rapper from New York who grew up extremely wealthy. Not rich, but wealthy. I think that's a very, very important distinction to make. He grew up wealthy. Like, the dude went to a private school, like in high school or something like that, that costed about $60,000 a semester, somewhere around there. In high school. So this dude didn't grow up rich. He grew up.
I mean, I feel like he just playing like the look. His whole character is more like a gimmick. That would have given with me. Like, I saw a little, like, one of his videos he did. Well, I forget that rapper name. But it like, his whole character is pretty much like a gimmick to me. That would have given me, though. It's like a gimmick. Yeah, it's so much, but let's hear it. It's so much.
Wealthy. And his entire gimmick is that, hey, look at me. I'm a rich white kid who does drill music. Isn't that crazy? Like, wow, I'm so different, right? He grew up rich, but now he goes to the hood occasionally and films music videos or hangs out with rappers. Like,
I mean, yeah. Like, he got to pay, but he got to pay them. Like I said, money talk when it comes to rappers, bro. Like, if you got that much, enough money to pay them, bro, money talk, man. They'll do it.
Didi Osama, Fabio Foreign, or whoever else he can pay to be a feature on his music. And in this video, I'm going to explain to you why you should not like him. And I'm going to start with the smallest stuff leading up into the bigger stuff.
That mediocre.
Lil Mabu is an extremely mediocre rapper, mid as the kids would say. His music's not like terrible though, like it's listenable. It's not like super trash, but like it's just kind of there, right? And that's not a crime. There's nothing wrong with making mediocre music. That doesn't make you any sort of evil or anything like that. But the thing about Lil Mabu is the amount of hype and I guess you could say success slash numbers he receives is not proportionate to the amount of talent that he has.
Look at this man, 22, so sorry, Jack.
He has, and that's mostly due to the way that he markets himself.
Yeah, I'm gonna say it's just how he markets himself. That's all it is.
Hundreds of drill artists who are just as good, if not better, than Lil Mabu right now. And so you're probably thinking to yourself, well, if he's not that good, but his marketing is good enough to make him popular, what's wrong with that? Like, there's nothing wrong with, you know, marketing yourself. Like, why are you mad at that? His entire marketing scheme, the entire way he promotes himself is just, I'm a drill rapper, but I'm white and rich. That's pretty much it. And I actually went to a really nice school and graduated. And also now I'm going to college. So him being a rich white kid in a predominantly black and impoverished space gives him a novelty that he is very well aware of and plays into heavily. And honestly, at this point, he's just kind of annoying. This isn't anything too bad. It's just very annoying because...
Yeah, I mean, I feel like some people might... I feel like some people just use hip-hop just to get the money and run off with it. So that, you know, that part, that'll get to me. I feel like they just in it just for the quick cash, and then they finna leave. They bouncing. They finna leave. That's why I'm like, man, crazy. But they letting people doing it.
If he was your average Bronx kid who grew up, a regular black kid who made drill music, nobody would talk about him. His music.
Bro, I don't even listen to drill music like that. The last drill music I be listening to was from Chicago. It's too many lead New York drill and like the beats. Like the hi-hats. I don't know, man. That could be random, but man, I understand it's different and it's unique in their way. So
would be under the radar. Nobody would really care. It wouldn't be too bad. Maybe he would have a little bit of buzz, but he wouldn't be a social media star or anything of the sort. And honestly, to put this into shorter context that may even make a little bit more sense, I want to show you clips of Dennis Rodman and Isaiah Thomas talking about Larry Bird in the 80s. And this is exactly how I feel about Lil Mabu.
I said, if Larry was a black guy, he just would be a regular old basketball player. And I didn't realize what I said, you know.
And someone ran over with that comment and asked Isaiah Thomas, your teammate said something. Do you agree with it?
A very, very good basketball player. I think he's an exceptional talent, but I'd have to agree with Rodman. If he was black, he'd be just another good guy.
Now, if you know anything about basketball, you know that Dennis Rodman and Isaiah Thomas were just completely wrong about Larry Bird. Like,
hey, Larry Bird was a beast, man.
It couldn't have been further from the
Celtics. Team.
And honestly, that was like hating to the furthest extent where you just start making stuff up. But if you take out, you know, basketball, replace it with drill rap, take out Larry Bird and put in Lil Mabu, the statement is 100% accurate, and that's how I feel about Lil Mabu's music.
Uppercut.
Tell me who this sounds like. Pretending to be from an area you were never from, cosplaying as a gangster, surrounding yourself with real gangsters in your videos and things of that nature, getting features from real gangsters to boost your street cred, inserting yourself in a genre and a lifestyle in which you've never lived that's also filled with death, despair, and a lot of agony. And
I'm gonna say Lil White. He's trying to be like Lil White. I don't know if y'all know who Lil White is. It was that Lil White rapper from Chicago, I believe. I could be wrong now. I'm giving Lil White. I could be wrong. I'm gonna say Lil White.
And planting clips of yourself being gangster, faking clips of you being gangster, having clips of you clutching your pole without security. Who does this all sound like? It should sound like Lil Mabu, of course, because that's who the video is about. But in reality, I was Lil talking White. About 6ix9ine. Lil Mabu is doing 6ix9ine. What 6ix9ine did back in the day without fully committing to the role like 6ix9ine.
I forgot about 6ix9ine. Dang, I thought it was Lil White.
Did and actually making worse music than 6ix9ine did back in the day. All of the things people hated about 6ix9ine when it came to like inserting himself into the culture and being kind of a culture vulture and being an outsider who put himself at the forefront of something he's not really involved in is what Lil Mabu did. Lil Mabu just didn't go as far as 6ix9ine in terms of like really thinking he was a gangster. All of the things people hated about 6ix9ine when it came to like him inserting himself into gang culture when he was never really like that can be applied to Lil Mabu as well, minus like the weird allegation stuff that 6ix9ine has going on. It's very clear that Lil Mabu basically just saw the rise of New York drill in 2019 into the future and just copied it. Like, if you look at his music pre like 2019 and post, it's night and day. He went from like Matty B raps type of music to like
no,
trash juice.
Not Matty B. I ain't heard that. God, Matty B, that's crazy. Juice World.
Juice World music, and then into like copying K-Flock. The only real difference between
nah, that crazy Matty B
between 6ix9ine and Lil Mabu is that 6ix9ine fully committed to the gangster role. 6ix9ine was really out here getting people beat up, getting people shot at, putting money on people's heads. He was really out here thinking he was a gangster and kind of moving accordingly all the way up until he got arrested for the RICO charge. So maybe that's why 6ix9ine was able to go a little bit further in the music industry than Lil Mabu has at this point. Maybe Mabu needs to officially join a gang or something like that. But honestly,
I don't think he's gonna do all that. He ain't no dumb kid. Well, I don't think he's gonna go that far.
Not fully committing is probably why he's still kind of safe in the streets. He doesn't have any like real beef, and he also doesn't have any legal troubles like 6ix9ine, so I guess there's a give and take there. So for all the people who say, oh my god, Lil Mabu's a genius, he's master manipulator, master marketer, he saw the game, and he 6ix9ine already did it. Like, he's not the first person to do it, and 6ix9ine wasn't the first person to do it, so really he's not doing anything too special, and it's just kind of scummy.
One of the
things people most give Mabu credit for is him being a master marketer. He's a genius marketer. But really, for the most part, a lot of the attention he gets on himself from his marketing is kind of cheap attention. And what I mean by that is it's not anything that's like really, really smart or anything super crazy. Like, a lot of the times it's him paying for blogs to post about him at high school. Oh, Lil Mabu just graduated. Lil Mabu's at college or whatever. And also it's him faking videos of him having guns or whatever, or him clutching, or why you lacking, bro? I'm not lacking. Look at
why you lacking?
Lacking? You mean, bro?
Like, oh, you know where you at right now? Like, bro, I really take everything off you, bro. Like,
I'm outside Dolly, you know, Mabu's body, bro.
Yo, Mabu, like, what you got on you? Like, oh, he got the now.
It's a lot of really.
I ain't gonna lie, that was kind of cringe. I ain't gonna hold you.
Cheap attention that pretty much anybody with a little bit of paper can do. Mabu is a master of what people in wrestling would call a cheap pop. A cheap pop is when a wrestler is able to get the crowd to at least momentarily cheer for them using something that is very cheap and pretty much anybody can do. That's why it's called a cheap pop, because there's not a lot of substance to it.
Night Raw, right here in Providence, Rhode Island.
He does a lot of things for attention that most people just probably wouldn't do or think is beneath him. And the biggest example of this is him and the whole Christian Rock situation. Mabu made a song with Christian Rock mostly because of her insane clout. And there's honestly nothing wrong with that. That's not what I'm mad about. A lot of people do that. They'll mess with people just because of clout. Drake does it. Kanye does it. Everyone does it. Everyone works with people because they're popping. But the part where it gets kind of weird and vulture-esque is when he inserts himself into the Christian Rock and Blueface beef. Mabu made the song with Christian Rock, which was dissing Blueface. So that's already one thing. I'm not too mad at that still, though. It's Christian Rock. You're trying to get some clout. Cool, whatever. But then he takes it a step further and starts beefing with Blueface outside of the song, strictly for garnering attention on himself and the song that he just put out.
That's
he
crazy.
Starts going at Blueface, sending messages on Twitter and stuff, talking about Blueface's other baby mama, Jaden. He even starts trying to act like he's like Christian's new boyfriend, which is kind of weird. And Christian herself didn't really like.
That's how I felt, though. Like, bro, I know we working, but back up, you know? Like, stop. I don't know who got it, but the whole time, every time he would like do too much, I'd be like, back up, or he'd expect me to do another
one. And then there's like a photoshopped picture of Christian Rock. She has this tattoo right by her like lower stomach area, let's just say, and it says Jonathan's P-word. Terrible tattoo, I know, but Mabu photoshopped it to say Mabu's P-word and then sent it to a whole bunch of blogs.
Nah, that dude trying to get some engagement.
Allegedly, at least. Allegedly, Mabu did that. I'll say that. I don't know if he did it for sure.
Oh.
I love Mabu to death. He cool. He my man. But he drove way too hard. He gonna put Mabu pussy.
Oh, you didn't think about that. Wait, you didn't know he put it on there?
No.
It's one thing to work with Chris Sean Rock. I 100% get it. A lot of people are doing it right now. I'm not even mad at that. But you got to really look at what Mabu did. It's another thing to see a toxic couple online, literally one of the most toxic couples in the history of the internet, see multiple instances of domestic violence, them fighting all across America, pretty much in public, at home, on Instagram Live, her stealing his car, her breaking into his house, all types of stuff, child neglect, child denial, child indecent exposure by Blueface. It's another thing to see all of those things and then want to insert yourself in the middle of the relationship.
That's crazy.
Not just get a little clout off Chris Sean Rock, but insert yourself in the middle of the relationship and start beefing with Blueface. That's just weirdo behavior. He saw all of those things and thought, this is my opportunity to get some clout. Now, this is just one example of Mabu being a vulture, but literally his entire inclusion into drill music itself and drill culture, I guess, is him being a vulture. Lil Mabu is a peak exploitation artist. He has exploited the drill music itself and the artist that he has paid to work with him for clout and money. And to really understand this, we need to look at what drill really is as a subgenre of rap. Drill music is a subgenre of rap that is filled with violence, death, pain, loss.
It started all in Charette, but some people say it started all in UK. I mean, when I first heard drill music, I heard it from Chicago, straight up Charette, bro. When my brother put me on, my baby brother, he put me on Cheeky, Don't Like. I'm like, okay. Hey, yo, after that, I just been listening to a whole lot of them. That was back then, though, bro. I wonder if Cheeky still make music there. God, it's been so long. But I still listen to Lil Durk, though. I still listen to Lil Durk on and off, though. But not like that anymore. Well, I still listen to Lil Durk on and off, though.
Dissing and despair. This is because of the surroundings that need to exist in order to create drill music in the first place. Gang culture, guns, gun violence, death of friends, family members, all of these things have to exist in order for drill music and drill artists to exist. Except for Lil Mabu. Lil Mabu comes in and goes through none of the emotional trauma that comes with the lifestyle that actually births drill music and begins to partake in the art form. Now, he's not the first ever insider to come into hip hop and
outsider,
not experience any of the culture really and partake in the art form. And he won't be the last, but there's just something really sinister about doing that with drill music of all subgenres of rap.
Yeah, I'm saying if drill music, all things, you decided to go on drill music. Oh, God, sad.
So as a drill artist who's never lived the lifestyle, you are essentially jumping in and getting money and fame off of a genre that literally only exists because of countless death, pain, murder, violence, and everything in between. Drill music is filled with real rappers, or at least it's supposed to be filled with real rappers who have actually gone through things. Now, obviously, we all know Lil Mabu hasn't gone through anything that he raps about or anything that his peers rap about. That's not really a secret. But Lil Mabu could literally make any genre of music, any subgenre of rap even. He's done it before in the past. But he decided to...
He sat the top on into the most dangerous ones in that drill. He liked the injuration and all that.
Insert himself into the genre that is filled with and built off of young black kids' pain. And dang. I know some people are going to try to defend Mabu like, well, it's just cap rap. Other rappers cap.
But yeah, that's what I said. Lil White. Lil White, he did it too. But you saw what happened to Lil White now. Same thing can happen on that Lil Mabu dude.
Cap rap all the time. Like, what's wrong with embellishing your life in your rhymes? Wouldn't you rather him be lying about drilling than actually going and doing the drilling and actually hurting people?
I understand it's art, but some people miss the point.
Obviously. But there's a difference between Lil Tecca throwing in a bar here and there about guns that he doesn't own.
Who twin Glocks turn you to a dancer? I don't have no straps for nobody.
Versus Lil Mabu rapping consistently about drilling and sliding and the ops he slid on and making fake videos where he's clutching and making videos where he's caught lacking by the ops. Like, there's a major difference between those two things. There's a difference between throwing in some cap rap here and there and being an entire cap drill artist. And for the idiots in the back, obviously it's better for him to be lying about drilling and sliding and be playing pretend in his music. Obviously that's better than him actually doing those things, then going and rapping about it. But hot take, just do neither.
Yeah.
You don't have to be a drill artist, Lil Mambo. You don't have to rap about all this stuff. He can just not do either of those things. And to give you an analogy for what I'm saying, if you still can't really understand what I'm trying to say, imagine this. Imagine there is...
I mean, most likely it's probably going to be like some of the young people that don't understand it. But you know, I guess it. I clearly understand it.
A child abuse support group. And let's just say these people were really badly abused as children. Like, I don't just mean like your average whooping that, you know, black kids get. I mean, they were beaten bad, bruised, sent to school, black eyes. Their parents didn't feed them. I'm talking the worst of the worst. Okay. The worst child abuse you can pretty much imagine. Now, imagine there was a support group for that type of child abuse. And these people were getting online and they were telling their stories to the world. And they were starting to blow up. Members from this group of child abuse victims who grew up and maybe, you know, went on and did great things in their life. They're telling these stories and they're blowing up online. They're becoming celebrities. They're getting interviews. They're on, I don't know, Ellen. Let's say Ellen's still around. They're doing all these things. They're making money. They're becoming real stars based off of them telling the story of their trauma and how they overcame it. Imagine if that was a group, right? Now, imagine if one member came in and they started really telling their story, and it was a really miraculous story. They came in, told their story, and people were like, wow, that's crazy. You deserve all your flowers. You deserve fame. You deserve money, all these things. And they started to get fame and money. Now, imagine if that person was found out to be faking it. That person was never abused as a child.
Just clout chasing.
That person grew up in a happy, healthy, rich family. They never had any problems in their childhood, and they were just faking like they were a child abuse victim. Obviously, that would be really bad thing. Everyone would be up in arms talking about it. It'd be all over the news. People would be ridiculing them, talking crazy. They would be, oh my, it would be the worst thing ever. That person would be getting so much hate. And imagine how real child abuse victims would feel. They would feel just horrified that someone would take their story and lie about it. Imagine how the kids who are currently going through child abuse would feel about that. They would be, oh my God, it would be horrible, right? Now imagine telling those people who are mad about that person lying about their child abuse story, well, at least they didn't actually get abused. What, you wanted them to actually be abused? You're mad that they didn't get abused? You see how goofy that sounds? Even if the faker goes on to tell these fake stories of child abuse and how they overcame it and the individual stories are all fake, and they're telling you now, hey, now I'm going to come out and tell you guys that these stories are fake, it would still be weird and people still wouldn't want them to do it. And that's exactly how I feel about Lil Mambo. Obviously, it's a great thing he grew up in a good two-family, two-parent household, whatever, with a whole...
Yeah, but he should not be rapping about drill, though, but I guess he loves it.
Bunch of money. That's crazy. Great. I'm glad he didn't have to grow up drilling and killing and seeing his friends die. That is 100% a good thing. Nobody's mad that he hasn't gone through what the other drill rappers are going through or have gone through. People are mad and I'm mad and I don't like him because nobody told him to pose as a drill rapper. You don't have to do that. Nobody needs you to do that. He's exploiting the real pain and trauma that typically come with the people involved in the genre. But everyone's just like, hey, it's okay because he's making money, though. You can't even be mad, bro. He's making money, bro. How you going to be mad?
Yeah, that's the part I feel about it. Like, the ones that really are, like, expressing their pain and feelings. Like, bro, I would listen to old buddy when I first heard, what his name, from Chicago. Montana 300, bro. When I first heard him, he did that Chirac freestyle. I'm like, bro. This dude can rap. He can freestyle. But it was just so much negative and pain, bro. Like, oh my God, bro. This is, it was so much, though, for me to take in. Like, God, I hope he's doing all right, though. I'll be listening to him, though.
Matt. Lil Mambo is the culmination of how the media covers rap, specifically gangster rap. Internet media covering drill and the deaths that are involved in it and the beefs and stuff, the way in which they do, which is very similar to the war in Chirac that DJ Academics did like 10 years ago.
I used to check out all that stuff right now, bro. I'd be like, what going on in Chirac, bro? What going on in Chicago?
I know why we are where we are today, because they treat these gangster rap beefs, these drill beefs, these drill deaths like it's an anime. Like they're talking about anime characters or superhero
characters.
No. They, and Lil Mabu included, see the people in the genre not even really as like real people, but kind of like characters almost. And that's why you can see somebody like Lil Mabu in his music videos fantasizing about getting shot or chasing down the ops and shooting at them and not think anything of it. Not considering the very real people who have to.
Yeah, I feel like, when I saw the video, I feel like, dang, I don't know if he making fun of the people that got shot. And, like, you know, it's just so much going on. Like, I don't know, man. But, you know, that's crazy, though.
Go through these things every single day or have gone through these things, and that has completely changed their life forever. He does these things in his videos and doesn't even think about it. It's just kind of like very surface level. Hey, this is kind of what rappers do in their videos, so I'm going to do it too. There's really no resonating in these type of situations for Lil Mabu just because he's really so far away from it. Like, it's just never been his reality or probably ever going to be his reality. So he can just kind of do it and not really necessarily think of it. Maybe not maliciously doing it to like make fun of the people who have died, but he just kind of does it. Doesn't really think about it. Doesn't have to. But on the other end of the spectrum, it's exactly why somebody like Lil Mabu would never reenact a school shooting in his video or pretending to be a victim of a school shooting in a video, because that's something that he can actually kind of feel. That's something a little bit more tangible to him and something he can more really feel himself in the shoes of, rather than being on the blocks of Brooklyn and running around the corner from the ops and they shoot you in the shoulder. Like, that's something that's a little bit far-fetched, but somebody walking into the classroom with an AK is something that all Americans can kind of at least visualize. That's why he wouldn't really ever touch that. So for all those reasons, I really don't think you should like Lil Mabu. I really think you should dislike the guy, especially if you consider yourself an actual fan of rap music. I mean, if you just listen in passing, whatever, go ahead, do your thing. But if you actually really enjoy rap music and hip-hop culture, I don't think you can be a fan of Lil Mabu. And honestly, another thing that I'm just adding on, just because, I really don't like the guy. He's just annoying as hell. Just throwing that out there. I know some people are going to watch this video and be like, bro, it's not that deep, bro. You're looking too far into it, bro. You're hating on Lil Mabu. You're just... That's
cool. That hit young fans, bro. That hit young fans that going to say something like that. I already know.
Cool, this video is not for you. And there's going to be some people who are going to be like, well, he's still super successful and has all this money, bro. He has all this money. That's great. Good for him. I think as a society, we have started to move away from calling people lame even when they have money. Like, bro, just because you have money, that doesn't mean that your character is any better than anyone else's, all right? I think we need to kind of bring that back as a society, because me personally, I don't care how much money you have. If you're lame, I'm just going to call it how I see it. If I don't like you for a specific reason that I think is actually valid, which I think I laid out some pretty valid reasons in this video, I'm going to express that. So we need to stop that whole, well, they got money. Well, he has money, so.
I don't give a fuck.
I don't care, all right? I don't care. I don't like the guy. I think he's lame. I think a lot of the stuff he does is corny. And I think I expressed that in a very mature and actually well put together way in this video. I think I made some valid points, at least.
I know. I bet bro, comment section gonna be filled with like, bro, you just hating on him.
I think I did. Maybe I didn't. Who knows? But I think I did. But this video is for all the people who don't really know how to feel about Lil Mabu, or they're in the middle and they're like, I don't really know about this guy. This video is for you. And also for the people who are wondering why I don't like Lil Mabu, this video is also for you. I could probably say more, but I'm just going to end it here just because I feel like I said enough and I think you get the point. But if you made it this far, I greatly appreciate it. If you left a like, a subscribe, did all that, whatever, I greatly appreciate it. If you're going to leave a hate comment, whatever, if you're going to screenshot it and send it to Lil Mabu, do whatever you got to do, bro. If you made it this far, I appreciate it regardless. Have a good day. Be safe. Be blessed. Peace.
And there you go, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, yo, I'm not mad, man. Everyone's entitled, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't listen to the guy like that, so. But I see the stuff they be doing and stuff. I'm like, man, dude rapping, pretty much a gimmick. But you already know, man. Link up in the description to know what I like this stuff. I'm out.